Hi friends, welcome to Spartan GRE. In this video, we'll be solving the question which you can see in the background. This question is posted by Sandeep Raut Chetri in Spartan GRE official Facebook page. So, the purpose of making this video is many people ask me for a technique to solve these kind of variable based questions within a less time and with accuracy, right? So, before watching this video, pause the video and solve it on your own. Then, also make sure you solve this question in less than a minute, because our target is solving any question in less than a minute and with accuracy, 100% accuracy, right? Fine. Now, I hope you solve this question. Now, see this. Many people, what they do is, as and when they see these variable based questions, they try to plug in the values, right? In such cases, plugging in values is not a wrong approach. In such cases, what you have to do is, you have to check for all the edge cases, because if you miss one edge case, you will get a wrong answer, right? So here you have two losses. One, you are wasting your time, and finally you are ending up with a wrong answer. So be careful while solving the questions. Your observation plays a crucial role. Here, before as and when you see the questions, don't bluntly jump and plug in values. What you can do is, by observation, here you have 5, here you have 6, right? And here you have 5, here you have 6. What I will do is, I will try to eliminate 5 and 6 because both are common in both the quantities, right? Now, how can I eliminate 5 and 6 here? I can eliminate by taking LCM, right? So, if I take LCM here, it will be 6A minus 5B by 30. Now, here 6B minus 5C by 30. Now, I can remove this 30 here, I can remove this 30 here, right? Now, I am left with 6A minus 5B. In quantity A, I'm left with 6B minus 5C in quantity B, right? Now, he said A, B, C are consecutive integers in increasing order. So, your C will be greater than B will be greater than A. This is the order, right? Also, in one of the number systems videos, I told you, whenever you are asked for consecutive integers, you can take like this. A minus 1, A plus 1, right? So, you can take your numbers as like this, A minus 1, A, and A plus 1, this is A plus 1, right? Now, this will be my C, this will be my B, this will be my A, right? Because these are my consecutive numbers and my numbers are ABC in increasing order. So, I can take A as A minus 1, B as A, and C as A plus 1. Now, what I will do is, here 6A minus 5B is there, 6B minus 5C is there. Here we have 3 variables, right? I will try to reduce the variable count. What I can do is, if I try to eliminate B here, what I have to do? I have to add plus 5B. So here 6A minus 5B plus 5B. So what it will be? You will be left with 6A here. Now here, I have to add the same 5B in the RHS also, another quantity also. Here I will be, it will be 6B minus 5C plus 5B. So this will be 11B minus 5C, right? Till here you can do orally, everything will be orally solved here, right? So now what I will do is, I will take these values. A means A minus 1, so put it here. So 6 into A minus 1, it will be 6A minus 6. This is done. Now, in place of B, put A, in place of C, put A plus 1. Why I am doing like this is, I am trying to, first I reduce the number of variable count. A, B, C is there, I made it to only one variable here and two variables here, right? Now what I'm doing, I'm again replacing these variables with one variable. So again, I'm converting A, B, C into simple one variable A. How can I do that? So B, I will take it as A here. So it will be 11A minus 5C. In place of C, I'll take A plus 1, right? So minus 5 into A plus 1. It will be 11A minus 5A minus 5. So this will be 6A minus 5. Here you have 6A minus 6. Now see here, earlier we have two variables in quantity A, two variables in quantity B. Now, if in total we have three variables, I have converted this question into a single variable of A. Now here you have 6A, you have 6A here. How can I cancel 6A in both the cases? Just simply do minus 6A here, do minus 6A here. So 6A minus 6A cancel. 6A minus 6A cancel. Now your question is converted into constant parts. Earlier it is variable part, now constant part. Now here you are left with minus 6 in quantity A and you are left with minus 5 in quantity B. So you can straight away say your answer is quantity B because minus 5 is greater than minus 6, right? So in this case, in this method, we haven't used any plugging and values, right? Normal way of solving this question is, he said A, B, C are consecutive integers. So what are the values you are going to take? So if you try solving this question in a traditional way, you have to check all the edge cases. Three consecutive integers means they can be negative, they can be positive. So I have to club them, or it can be not positive, not negative also. So I can take my numbers like this, A, B, C are minus 3, minus 2, minus 1, where I am taking all are negatives. Now I will take all positives, 1, 2, 3 I can take, right? Now I will include 0 along with the negatives. So I will take minus 3, minus 2, 0. This is also one possible case. So consecutive integers I said. So I can take minus 2, minus 1, 0. So I included 0 with the negative numbers. Now I will include 0 with positive numbers. So I can take as 1, 0, 1, 2. See, all these are called edge cases. So if you try solving this question in a traditional way, you have to plug in these values, this one, this one, this. So four particular value sets you have to plug in these variables. Now you can see how much time consuming it will be, right? So I hope this video is useful for you. Try applying this logic wherever you see variables, right? So please do share this video so that it reaches to larger audience. Thank you.